Welcome back, and time for a new question. So let's just jump in and get started straight away. This is the question that we're going to be looking at in this lesson. The question is, you've been asked to design a system for the secure viewing and distribution of medical imaging data. The platform stores images of various sizes on S3 and caches them globally using CloudFront for delivery to customers. All behaviors have trusted signers added, but you found out that customers can still access the data without authentication, and this is unacceptable for sensitive data. What option should you suggest? And the question indicates to choose one. Now, as before, we need to do some keyword identification and highlight what matters for the scenario and potentially what can influence answer selection. So let's do that first. And as always, if you want to try this first, then go ahead, pause the video, take the time to review the question yourself, and then resume when you're ready to compare. Okay, so this is what I've identified in the question. What we know is that the platform stores images, and it stores these images in S3, and then it caches them using CloudFront. We don't, at this stage, have any knowledge of the configuration of the S3 bucket, and that's important to selecting an answer. If the question stated any specific permissions via bucket policies, then that would at least give us some idea. But at this stage, we don't know any of that. But maybe the answers will provide some additional information. Maybe not. What we also know is that the CloudFront distribution has multiple behaviours, and they all have trusted signers which have been added. Now, this is actually a keyword to specifically look out for in the exam. It means that the behaviour has been configured to be private, meaning that pre-signed URLs or cookies are required to access objects which are cached by the platform. Finally, at the bottom, we're told that customers can access data without authentication, and this is massively important because it seems on the surface to conflict with the trusted signers point earlier in the question. If a behavior is set to be private, this means it needs signed URLs or cookies to access it, but if the data can still be accessed, then that points to a misconfiguration that we need to identify or resolve. Now, how did you compare with what I've identified in this question? Did you get a similar set of keywords? If so, awesome. If not, then just keep refining your skills as you go through this set of lessons. But now it's time to review the answers, so let's quickly look at how many answers we have and exactly what each of them looks like. So we've got a total of 4 answers to this question. Once again, the first step is to review the answers, looking for keywords or anything of significance based on the question. So go ahead, pause the video, review the answers yourself, and then in a few moments, you can compare with what I find. Okay, so now let's look at what I identified in the answers, and you can compare with anything that you identified. Now, these are the key elements which I identified in the answers, and to save time, let's jump straight into the answers and evaluate what about them makes them valid versus invalid. And we're going to start with the top answer. Now, this answer suggests that we add an S3 bucket policy to restrict access to the AWS or web identities attempting to access the bucket. Now, the problem here is twofold. First, the question is stating that customers are accessing the system using CloudFront. So any answer which mentions S3, you have to be immediately critical of. Don't exclude it, but treat it with a little bit of caution. The answer also talks about adding web identities to the bucket policy, and that's not something that you can do natively. Bucket policies are used to either grant open access or to add specific AWS identities. You can't natively add web identities without using Web Identity Federation, and that's not mentioned in the question, and so I'm going to exclude this top answer. Now, the second answer is actually a tricky one. It says to change the CloudFront distribution to be private, preventing any unauthenticated access to the S3 buckets, and there are 3 things wrong with this answer. The first is that it states a CloudFront distribution. This isn't the thing that's set to private or not. You learned in the theory lessons that configuring parts of CloudFront to be private or restricted is something configured on a behavior within a distribution, so not the distribution itself. Secondly, the question tells us that trusted signers have been added already, and this means the behaviors are already private. And third, even if all of this were true, this wouldn't actually prevent direct access to the content using S3. CloudFront and S3 are separate products. CloudFront being private via trusted signers doesn't impact the ability to access S3 directly. You can still bypass CloudFront unless you make specific configuration changes, and so we're eliminating this answer as well. Now, the reason why this answer is wrong, it actually also shows us what the right answer is, but more on this in a second. The last answer suggests using SSE-KMS on the S3 bucket and then to restrict the CMK or customer master key to the web identities who require access. Now, this one is just wrong. SSE-KMS is a server-side encryption feature. Also, as with bucket policies, restricting the CMK to web identities isn't something that it's designed for, and so this answer needs to be excluded. This leaves us with answer 3, which is the correct answer, but we need to know why. The answer suggests creating an OAI, which is an origin access identity, updating the distribution and then adding a bucket policy. The problem the question scenario details is that they've configured a CloudFront distribution, they've used an S3 origin, and configured the behaviours to be private by adding trusted signers. This means access via CloudFront is restricted, but nothing about this prevents people going directly to S3 and bypassing that restriction. An origin access identity is a virtual identity which can be assigned to a CloudFront distribution. Once done, the bucket policies can be configured to only allow access from that identity. That means all access to data within the S3 bucket has to come via CloudFront. And because CloudFront is configured to be restricted, any accesses to that S3 bucket via CloudFront have to conform to the restrictions placed on that distribution and any of its behaviours. So I hope that made sense. It's a fun question. It just takes practice to start identifying what a question scenario means, and then that allows you to select the right answer. Now, don't worry if you find this difficult at first. There are many more questions that you can practice with in this section of the course. You just need to keep refining your skills, keep practicing these questions, and by the time you make it to the full practice exams later in this section, as well as the full certification exam, you should have got the hang of it. At this point, though, thanks for watching. Go ahead, complete this lesson, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.